Going into some nickname game over here. Hey, Mom Tendo, what is Druzy talking about? Taylor, she's got her own emote? Are you serious? Dude, that's insane. Alright, we're going into this. David Q and Haunter, 64. Falco's over here getting those dares in nice. That's what I like to see. Falco's dares are effing sick, man. Everyone knows that. That's two stocks off of Marth. Dude, like, I'm over here trying to talk to myself over here, man. Alright, so Falco putting in mad shines, putting in mad dares. That's what I like to see. You guys already know that because that's what I said before. Marth got a sick count in there. I don't think Marth's going to let this guy four stock him, though. We'll see what David Q's about, though. Ooh, he said he'll put him down. Ooh, but he can't grab the edge.
What's good? This is Cam Tendo, the proxy. Oh, no, Sam's coming back.
All right, so
I hope you guys are enjoying the stream. I'm out.
No four stock today. Dude, it was close. Kind of close. Well, I mean, closer than we've seen.
Alrighty.
And first game goes to David Q.
David Q's on the right, obviously. He's got the sick beanie on.
Sick beanie. It was a pretty solid match. He took control of it.
So what happened? What did I miss? Well, give a recap.
Yo, the recap. Falco dares again. Falco shines, then Falco dares again.
What's dare?
The downward area.
Oh. Okay.
Teams. Me and Blake are on a team. We're a commentary team. See, it's kind of right.
Kind of. Yeah, we're teams.
Cameron, get us off the screen. The game's on.
Going into round two.
Round two.
Oh, David Q decided to switch it up.
David Q is having no mercy.
Said he's gonna switch it from dares.
Haunter should evolve
into
Gongar because he needs to get. He needs to step it up.
Ooh, he landed right on
it's
that
a little more
tip,
even
though.
This life. Haunter's not messing around yet.
Ooh, counted right off. And I thought he could keep him off.
It's a shame when the talent is lacking in the front. It's got the front, but the talent doesn't have it in the... And the car doesn't have enough space in the storage space.
I know what you're saying, man. You got it. You can't just work on one skill set. You got to work on.
The car's got to be well-rounded. I mean, David Q is he's a well-rounded car.
Yeah, and that's why he's putting in work right here.
Okay, cool.
I thought he was going.
I want to push this easy button so badly,
dude. No four stock today.
Darn it!
It wasn't that
speaking
easy.
Of the JBM four stock. I doubt it though.
If he had gotten that shine, it would have been nice. Dude, no four stock today, Juzy.
JBM four stock, so I'll do it.
That was easy.
There was no four stock.
It was a JBM four stock. So I'll go. That was easy.
JBM four stock. JV four stock.
That's the one. JB four stock. The just barely four stock. Hey, is that where that we got
no,
it from?
JV.
JV.
Like junior varsity.
Oh.
He's learning, guys. He's learning.
I'm new. I'm the new guy.
We wear stripes on Wednesdays.
We wear stripes on Wednesdays.
Why so serious? Shout out to Harry Potter. Shout out to, what's his name, Daniel on BuzzFeed.com. He was watching Harry Potter for the first time in his life. He's a 31-year-old guy, I think is what he said. And he's been watching every Harry Potter movie every couple weeks, and he does a BuzzFeed article. It's hilarious. For anyone that likes Harry Potter, go on to BuzzFeed, search for watching Harry Potter for the first time. That is it's hilarious.
Sam, please. Please.
Sam, please. I'm just saying, Druzy, you need to calm it down.
Druzy is
Harry
bad.
Potter's brought to you by Farmageddon 2 next weekend. Midland Warfare.
Next Saturday.
Next Saturday, the 13th, at the University of Louisiana Student Union.
Yep, sign-ups are at noon.
I'm just kidding. Nebraska, Louisiana. Okay. University of Lincoln, Nebraska, Lincoln. Sign-ups at noon. Mom's throwing shade my way because I'm pronouncing things wrong. Calm down, Mom. I'm in college. I can handle myself. I'm a college chick here for a scholarship.
This dude. Oh, wait. What were we supposed to do?
Follow hype.
That's right. Follow hype. Follow but there's no hype. Follow hype. False alarm, everyone. No follow hype. Oh, calm it down. You trying to get big right now, bro? Druzy's coming at you, though.
That's fine. He's
Dude, we about to do it right here?
I don't know what we're doing. I'll have a conversation with him.
Dude, man, it's about to go down over here,
I'm
man.
Not sure what's going
it's
down.
It's about to go down.
What's it?
Dude, get those bars ready to drop, man. This dude, it's
rap.
About to start.
I don't know if you guys can see my skin color.
Dude's got his
I'm
own
not
mixtape.
I'm not Eminem.
Dude's got his own mixtape
that
out.
That is a lie.
Don't even.
I played trombone in from 6th to 8th grade. So, I mean, if you want to download the band CD, you can. I can send it to you. That's about all I got going for me.
That's all I got.
That and my basketball highlights, which there weren't too many of.
Dang, yeah.
Being 6'4 only helps you so much. Practice time for this is Smeesh, right?
Mom Tendo.
Smeesh took off his stripes.
Spotting the grill in the background.
There's no grill.
Background of the player cam. All right, so we're getting the grill for y'all for the commentator cam.
What does that even mean? We get that in the background. Go Huskers.
Smeesh is going to take the first stock.
Oh, is this real? Oh, I thought they were still warming up. Okay.
No, that's JBM. He warms up for 10 minutes.
Oh, well, it didn't do him any good.
Oh.
Smeesh is just Donkey Konging all over everybody.
Yo, Druzy's calling follow hype. That's how you gotta say follow hype.
Follow hype.
Is it follow hype? Follow hype?
Follow hype.
No.
Follow hype. Is that how you say it?
Mom says no follow hype.
Mom says calm down, Drew.
Mom says calm down, Druzy. We know your mom, but calm down. We're just messing, man. We love you, Druzy. Dude, over here. Okay, so Druzy gave us a link to watch.
Mom, click the link. See what it is.
Mom, we got a video.
Okay, to get back to the game, Smeesh is destroying Shifty. It's just not even a contest.
No,
it's not a contest. Don't stop lying to the viewers. You're lying to the viewers.
All right, so that one goes to Smeesh. It's pretty.
They're not going to change characters. It's a surprise move for people to not change characters. After the match, maybe. No, Mom will not click that young man. He's having fun role-playing over there, isn't he?
Dude, look at Mom. Mom doesn't know what's going on.
Mom's hot pissed right now.
Mom's hot pissed. I don't know if y'all caught our... No, I thought you were doing a grill. Never mind.
I didn't do a grill. I drew an N. I didn't color it in, though.
Dude, that's not a...
Look at the colors.
It doesn't matter now because we're going into this
colors.
Match. Round two, Smeesh
is winning. Smeesh is up what? How much is Smeesh up?
49%.
Yep, that's right.
That's not even winning, really.
I'm going to laugh when Smeesh plays Noah. It'll be a great game. No, it will. I'm excited for that one.
You think this is a game? He is Mom.
No, she Mom's over Mom. There.
Dude, Mom Tendo is Mom.
Oh, shoot. What's the Japanese phrase again? I totally forgot it. Nonji desu ka? Oh, that's in the other room. Actually, it's 8:23 Central Time.
Central Time. Bro. I'm being in Twitch chat, please.
He's gone now. Damn it. Darn it.
That's unfortunate, yeah. So Shifty's lost one stock. Smeesh is keeping his lead alive. Ooh, but Shifty seems to be...
Shifty's putting up a fight. He's doing well. He's doing well. If he can get him down to three, it'll be an even fight here.
Not worth it. Not worth it.
What do you mean not worth it? He's on the edge.
What? He just lost the stock to, like, keep no.
I think he's confident in his abilities to succeed based on his past performances.
Maybe. Maybe that's true.
And he's got the tree on his side when I'm the tree. Oh, he was. Oh, my God. He punched him across the map.
Across the plane. Touchdown.
He put the team on his back, though. What happened? Excitement on TV.
We got some off-stream
hype. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's TV number 6. We got Brian Clymer versus a kid whose head and face I can't see. They're doing pretty fun over there. They're doing pretty fun is what I just said. So we're going to worry about that later.
I'm sure they're doing pretty fun.
They're doing pretty fun. Esports, welcome to ESPN 9. The
Niente?
Ouch. Is that what it is?
What
uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve.
Nueve.
ESPN 8, nueve. We can get Enrique Iglesias. Do you want to dance
bailando.
Contigo?
Bailando.
Bailando. Well, Shifty's gone. One life left. It's not looking good for him. This is still first game, correct?
No, this is
no,
second
game. Right. Smeesh is up 1-0. Yep. Oh, that's what the 1 and the 0 mean on the screen. That's great.
Dude is learning.
I figured that out by myself, guys. You're looking at the future of engineering right here.
Yep. This game.
I'm going to be building your bridges in about 5 to 10 years.
In 5
so don't
to
drive
10
on
years,
your bridges.
Don't drive on bridges. This dude's over here singing. It's we don't need any.
It's a musical game. Just get him off the edge. Smeesh has lives to burn. Shifty. Shifty's looking. I mean,
he's gonna put him.
I don't want to. I don't want to. I don't want to jinx him, but.
I don't know, man. The swag is real. Swag.
Shifty's not looking
dude,
too Juicy's bad.
Dude,
Juicy's
hyping
right
this chat up, yo. Shout outs to Juicy. Sure. There's a reason he's mod, and this is the reason.
You need to say it like Sean Connery. Swagger.
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 The swagger is
the
real.
The swagger is in the building. Mom Tendo, you're using your wrong handle name. He couldn't hear me. Mom, put your earpiece back in.
Donkey slam. And that's going to put Shifty away.
Donkey punted him all the way. All the way. Donkey's pounding his chest again because he's undefeated tonight.
He's undefeated.
Where's the bracket at?
Dude, Echo? So we're going to see Echo, the representative of Team Kai. We're gonna see on stream how good this Kai team is.
That'll be fun. I'm really excited for that. Well, we got B and North Face Jacket up next, so that's pretty exciting on the main screen.
Echo. Echo's really good.
Echo, is he?
Yeah.
So B doesn't stand a chance. Okay.
Echo
sorry,
was Echo's Millennium of Talented, of Awesome, right?
The Century of Talented, the League of Extraordinary
the
Gentlemen.
The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
TM. Cameron, where's the bracket? Mom, where's the bracket? Mom! Don't take away my toys. Mom's a mean person.
Come on, guys. 1 and 4.
14. We're in it.
Where's the bracket, Mom? I'm trying to inform our viewers, and you're not letting me.
Yo, can we see that one bid? That one video? Dang.
What is that, Mom?
Dang, yeah. Come on, Mom.
Pull it up over here.
You cold as ice, Mom.
Alrighty, so we got the rounds we got going here. Is it the loser's bracket?
This is losers.
Okay. Well, Shifty's down in the loser's bracket now. TBR Noah versus Ghoul Daddy and David Q versus Climber. They're in the winner's bracket. Loser's bracket, Shifty and McClay are waiting for their opponents right now. And we'll let it pop. Mom, get this off my screen. Thank you.
All right, so we're going into this. Echo versus B, just B.
Well, B Yee is his real name.
Yeah, his real name is B Yee.
I like to make it feel more personal to the viewers, but
all right, but like,
we need them emotionally involved, or they're not going to come back.
He chose. We'll only have
seven.
B
we'll man. Only have seven viewers forever if we don't use emotion.
How many viewers we have?
Nine.
Mom,
how many viewers we got?
11 viewers.
Holy
11
shnikes.
Viewer
we're
hype,
in, coach. Well. Cobra Kai Gymnasium Echo just fell off the edge.
Okay. Cobra Kai.
Cobra Kai Echo. B's looking pretty hot. All right,
so B's keeping this in it. All right.
B's doing really well.
Cobra Kai coming at him. He tried to throw a sword. He couldn't do it. Shy Guy's flying down looking for some screen time. Get off the screen.
Dude, he's got to pay those bills.
He threw a grenade. Where's the smash ball, Mom?
Dude, Mom won't tell us where the smash ball is. We'll figure it out.
Okay, I want to see the real champion here. Who in this room plays Luigi?
Dude,
I mean,
I'm going to be straight up. I don't think anyone in this room plays Luigi.
Why? He's obviously the best character.
I know there was someone who used to play Luigi, but he graduated, so he's
Luigi
not here
Luigi is
anymore.
Obviously the best. That's why I play as him in Mario Kart.
In Mario Kart.
He's the best.
Because this is the same thing.
Yeah, it's literally exactly the same thing. Someone's going to get a blue spike shell soon, and it's going to be crazy.
Ooh, man.
Super kick. Cobra Kai Gymnasium.
So it looks like Echo's about to bring this, almost tie this up. If he takes this stock, then he has to do some more damage, but still, dude's in this.
He is. He's doing pretty well.
He started off pretty bad, but I mean, he's
B.E.
brought it back.
To have such a great start, that's really great.
B.E. has got a noose around his neck right now. We call that a choke.
Oh, got him.
Never know what's going to happen, but
the BM.
The noose is around it, and we're going to see if it tightens.
We're going to see how this plays out.
Okay, B's handling his business.
Then again, he's at high
B, hit him with your broadside.
Ooh. Ooh. There's like nothing you can do
there
about that.
There it is, okay.
He ducked his grab, and then he punished him for grabbing. No dancing, no hugging.
I may be wrong, but I doubt it. Well, B's still doing pretty hot.
16
God,
viewers.
God, we're so awesome.
We got 16
Shout out
viewers,
to the
guys.
Five new viewers in the last whatever time space it is that it refreshes.
Time space. Shout outs.
Shout out to the time space continuum for letting us exist. Mom told us to do shout outs. I don't know.
We do shout outs.
We do shout outs because Mom said so.
Yep.
I'm going to change his name in my phone to Mom. Mom, too, because I already got my mom. I'll change my mom's name to Sue, and I'll change Cameron's name to Mom.
Dude says, you are more motherly than my mom.
He nags me more than Mom does.
Oh, kill.
Well, B's looking pretty sound here. He just has to get one more big hit on him, and it's probably over.
Cam's followers are known as Fantendos. That's why Druzy is mod.
Druzy, you can be the fourth member of our crew.
Yeah, we got Andy, and we need a fourth.
Game blouses. You want some grapes? Female dogs?
Female dogs.
Well, B's going into the second game pretty confident. Well, I mean, he only won one. He had, what, one stock left? So, I mean, he's confident because he had him down. He was down 4-2, but... We'll see how it goes for him.
Ooh, look at that duck.
Pretty even through the halfway through the first here.
I don't know. BE had quite a lead in the beginning.
I know, BE and then Noose tightened. Shout out to Birkenstocks for making some comfy, very comfy sandals.
This dude.
I walk around in them all the time.
Ooh,
we're still pretty even here. It's one big hit away from stocking him down.
Yeah, I feel like both of them are pretty much in kill percent.
This is a pretty, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if Echo came back here. Word on the street is Echo's pretty good.
Word on the street.
We're up in the streets. 18th. 18th.
18th.
B takes the first, causes the first death here, but then it's right back at it. We're tied again, ladies and gentlemen.
Echo's got that range until he runs into his own bomb.
Got him. Will anyone use the windmill to their advantage? The environment really plays a big big part in what you can do.
Yeah, definitely. That's why Pokemon Stadium's the best.
The broadside of the sword.
Destruction.
Destruction. The desolation of B.
The desolation of
Shout out to the UNL movie channel that plays The Desolation of Smaug like 8 times a day.
Literally, it's
God.
Ridiculous.
I love The Hobbit as much as the next dude, but come on. It's ridiculous. I own all 3 extended edition Lord of the Rings movies that are all 4 hours long, and I can't sit there and watch The Hobbit 2-3 times a day. Can't do it. Just can't do it.
I mean,
UNL needs to get some new movies. Her is weird and really depressing.
Her was great. I loved it. It just made me feel things I didn't want to feel.
Yeah, once
good.
Blake found out Samantha was in love. Spoiler alert.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Once Blake
whoa,
found
whoa,
out Samantha
whoa, whoa,
was in love
whoa, whoa,
with 640
whoa, whoa, whoa,
other
whoa.
People, it was GG's.
Dude is going to straight up spoil the movie.
Oh, I haven't seen it yet.
That's too bad. You should have watched it before I did.
God. This dude.
He said Druzy being accepted into the clique. Well, B's finds himself down 2-1 here. Quite a turn while we were chatting about movies. Echo's showing why his name's Echo. It comes back. The sound waves bounce back.
He comes back.
The bounce waves. You know, you send them away and they disappear, but then they bounce back. And they hit you in the face
back,
really
yeah.
hard with the broadside of their sword.
That with the sword. That's what Echo is.
Looking at Link, I remember for the longest time I thought his name was Zelda. As in any amateur, I mean, it's called The Legend of Zelda. Why would the main character be named Zelda? The chick's barely in the game. I mean, come on.
Dude, what are you talking about?
Ganondorf's best character.
Ganondorf. What was that one tweet? Scooby-Doo is the most useless character in the Scooby-Doo gang.
Is that DMX? You
that
guys
was
said
DMX.
Tweeted that. Shout out to DMX.
The show should be called Velma.
Or Fred, that ascot is
that
fantastic. It's fantastic.
All right.
Anyone
bro.
Who can rock an orange ascot and make it match. I mean, no, right. Or was it blue? I don't remember. I'm pretty sure it was orange. He wore a white sweater, blue undershirt, and like an orange ascot. He made it match.
Yep, he made it work.
Shout out to Freddie Prinze Jr. for playing a really good Fred in the live-action Scooby-Doo movie.
This dude over here going through all the
Shaggy
threats.
Looked like he was high 24/7. That dude smoked the weed.
Yo, Drew's
like Scoob, we got ourselves a mystery and a roll of weed over here.
Can you say weed on stream?
I don't
Is
know.
Cool?
Mom, can I say reefer on stream?
All right, we have confirmed.
That's
we
a really
say.
Hesitant nod, Mom.
We can't say
He's shaking
weed
his
on
head.
Stream.
I'm not going to say it again. Blake, I'm out of water.
That's unfortunate.
Let me have a drink of your water. Sure. Thank you. Appreciate it. Blake, let me get a drink of your water.
Dude can't wait. How is it?
Good, it's water.
All right, truth.
Truth or dare. I dare you to drink water.
I dare you to drink water.
So we're tied 1-1 here. B versus Echo. Echo's obviously playing Link and B's Marth. We'll see how this last game goes. B had a considerable lead. He was up 4-2 in the first game, but then Echo kind of found his stride last game. So we'll see what happens here.
We'll see what happens. I'm really excited to see a new team in this tournament that's not sponsored by Mom Tendo.
No kidding.
Dude,
shake your finger.
Mom's
at me,
over
Mom.
Here shaking his finger.
I only listen to Dad. Mom has no authority.
Mom has no authority.
He said, "Whoa, whoa, spoilers." Who the heck is Navi? Is he the little bug thing?
Hey, listen!
Thing is that... I couldn't... Cameron, what'd you tell me to do? You told me to play... what was the first Ocarina of Time? I made it about 20 minutes into that game. Couldn't handle the bad graphics and couldn't handle that little bug screaming at me every 5 seconds saying, hey, listen, go this way and ride your horse into the distance. I was tired of that.
We got some. I'd rather have
Cortana yell at me in that little bug. Shout out to Halo for being the best video game ever.
Dang, he said Halo's confirmed better than Legend of Zelda.
I'm a fan.
Mom's got a smile.
I'm a fanboy though. In all honesty, I need Halo.
These dudes and their fanboy status.
Fanboy, I am fanboy.
So it looks like Echo's up in this match.
I'm quitting Smash. Shots fired. Shout out to Druzy. Well, it's pretty even here. I mean, it's pretty even. This is actually
a
really
good
game.
Intense, yeah.
Yeah, and we're missing all of it because we're making dough. Thank you. Appreciate it. No, no worries. Hey, what? This dude is going to know my secret.
All right, B's down a stock. They seem to be trading blows left and right.
Left and right. B's got to make a move here. He's got to hit him with that broadside.
Make a move, Iceman.
X-Men reference, I love it.
Shout-outs to X-Men. Shout-outs to Iceman. Ooh, nice.
We're even here. B can come back. This is coming out of the clutch. Oh, shnikes. Link's got him. Dude, game. Blouses. Unless B can clutch this out.
Ooh!
Oh!
Hey! B
game over. B thought he had the handle and he got
trashed.
Good game, good night, and go grab some bench. You're done.
Oh,
in the loser. Well, wait, this is still the winner's bracket, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so B's got one more shot.
B's not out of this yet.
Go Huskers.
That's the end. We have no grill for you guys, but we do
grill.
Have an end.
You better get me some T-bones. We have a grill. I'm hungry.
This dude.
The man next to Blake knows my secret.
Got him. Dude, where's the bracket? What's coming up next?
Mom, where's the bracket? Where's Mom at? Stupid, am I? All right, so the bracket we got. I'm going to scroll up here. Smeesh and Echo are going to take it on in the winner's semifinals. Noah and Ghoul Daddy are about to go down. TVR Noah, the Television Radio Noah.
Yep, that's what their clan is.
That's what it stands for, right?
Television Radio.
Television Radio. Noah, do what you want. Don't let Mom tell you what to do. Don't listen to Mom. Don't listen to Mom. I never listen to Mom. Mom, what'd you do? Did Mom just kill the stream?
Dad killed the stream.
Dad killed the
How
stream.
How dare you kill the stream?
Dude, Dad's always messing up, yo.
Did we kill the stream, Mom?
Dude, how many viewers are we at?
Mom, how many viewers are we at?
11.
We're still 11.
We're at 11.
Everyone on the stream, I'm going to need you to call two of your friends.
Two of your friends, then have them call two friends. All y'all need to be watching the stream, yo.
We're getting into the semifinals.
Dude, I think we got a grill in the next tournament, guys.
A grill?
Yeah, it means girl.
Why do we call them grills?
Because sometimes you like mess up words and it's funny. And then you stick with it.
We've been schmeckledorfed. That's not even a word, and I agree with you. Is it over?
Button check.
Oh.
No.
Well, that's lame. I was hyped.
Television, radio, Noah is just that good.
He What's that? Pentatonix. Shout out to Pentatonix for being a great acapella group. What are they saying? Video killed the radio star. You ever seen those videos? They were on like this acapella challenge on TV in Pentatonix. They won it. And they sang Video Killed the Radio. I think I showed those to you last year. Yeah, those are some great videos.
They're pretty cool.
They were awesome. They did a Daft Punk one. That was really cool. Shout out to Daft Punk. I'm up all night to get lucky.
Shout out to Pharrell.
Because he's happy. Alrighty, well, Noah's up. What a surprise.
Noah's up 2 stocks.
Noah might give us our first 4 stock. Then I can finally push this easy button.
We'll see what happens, y'all.
I really want to push the easy button.
And there's a reason that they're in round 3 of this tournament, you know. There ain't no slouches.
There's a reason Noah wins every time.
Do we have a problem with Noah's name?
Come on, Mom.
So Mom's over here sleeping, but we got him.
Mom is awful at his job. Mom, you're awful at your job.
Got him.
No, I'm going to need you to get this 4 stock. I need it. I want to push the button so bad.
Dude, I don't think Noah's going to be able to do it.
No, dang it.
Commentator's curse.
Knock on fake UNL wood here.
UNL wood. It's all right, because I'm pretty sure Noah's got this one. Maybe next year.
And what a surprise. Noah's up 1-0.
Dude, is Tanner still in this? He didn't even say anything.
TVR Noah. Television, radio, Noah.
Television, radio, Noah.
Falco!
Mom.
You won't be Luigi.
Is Tanner still in this? Dang, yeah. Tanner didn't.
I like how he answers to Mom now, though. We've got it.
It's his name. Mom Tendo.
Wow, that was fast.
Yeah. That's how Noah likes to do things. You started off big. You started off with knees. It's the people's knees.
Well, that's what happens when you choose the lesser Mario brother. I mean, come on. Luigi over Mario. Easily. Luigi jumps higher.
Luigi jumps higher. That's the truth.
Back kick. He's down. 4-2. Dibs on pushing the button first if it happens.
Dude,
knock on wood.
We'll see, though. I don't think you can get it.
I don't know. Well, that's like you said, they're in round 3 for a reason.
Ooh, but then again, the Noah combos. But then again, Gould. Oh, never mind.
Wow, he got it. Wow, that was awesome.
All right, we'll see. We'll see how badly Noah wants to dish out these knees.
The Ooh, knee to a Falcone. Boom!
He's just going for up B's. Ooh, don't. Okay.
Oh, he missed it.
No. Can you put him away?
Come on, Noah.
Don't let him do
I'm a biased
daddy.
Commentator, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh! 4 stock.
That was easy.
Got him!
The four stock.
Noah gets a high five. I'm a biased commentator. There it is. He lived with me last year. It's okay. Is it really? All right.
He's hype over here, yo. There we go. Noah representing television, radio. That's what I like to see.
Brian Clymer next in fight.
Ooh.
Let's see what happens.
Ooh.
He's got the Huddle shirt representing Huddle swag. That's all Mom wears is Huddle shirts.
Yeah.
She's not trying to impress Dad anymore. Know who else? But if you do want to impress Dad, you'll attend Farmageddon 2 next Saturday,
Midland Warfare,
at the UNL Student Union, Saturday, September 13th. Sign-ups at noon. That's 12 p.m. post-mark.
Rumored,
is what that stands for.
Rumor has it that Halo Destiny will be there.
That's what I hear. I hear you can team up with your friends and bring Cortana back to life, Halo Destiny. That's the rumor. I also hear Modern Warfare 18 will be provided. So at
Modern Warfare 18.
That's the rumor again. So we'll see
another
what happens.
Another rumor, just the rumor. Don't quote us on that. All right, so we're getting into this match. Are they button checking? I think they're getting
into it. We button checking, Dad?
I don't know.
It looks like a button check.
Oh, it's real. We're live. What's the sign say, Mom?
It's over there. Please wait for Mom's thumbs up on stream.
I'm going to go change that. I'll be right back.
I'm going to change that. His soul is banned and sent to the Shadow Realm. That's unfortunate. So B Climber down a stock. Oh, it's because David Q's got the 69 packet. Never mind. It's gone.
We live in though. Blake's favorite line to use in the world.
Dude, it's a good line. Because we live in.
Yeah, we're living.
I can't go.
Oh, sorry, Dad.
I can't go. Alright, you good? You good? Alright. Woo! Fox answering back, but he's at pretty high percent. I feel like David Q can put him away like... Well, no.
Who David Q? Well, do we remember what who he beat? No, us? Was it me?
No. He beat... I can't remember who he beat. He beat someone. He's still in winners.
Well, obviously he beat someone. That's why he's here. Blizzy, excuse me. I have to use your handle.
I mean, it's just disrespectful.
Hey, shout out. Hey, if you're on Twitter, go follow Frosted Blake's 54. Is that what it is?
That's actually not it at
all.
What
is it?
Dude, you don't know. You don't know and you don't
know. I'm
going to
look it up right now.
Don't follow me on Twitter.
I'm going to get you to follow Blake on Twitter.
It's a bad idea. I don't tweet ever at all. You're just going to like.
No, he tweets.
You're just going to follow like an extra person for no reason.
That is not it. Bass Choco Thunder. That is B-A-S Choco Thunder. Follow it. That's Blake. And if you're really bored, follow at Sam Easy.
You're really bored.
I think I have some good tweets sometimes. So.
I literally never tweet.
No, duh. Well,
David
it's not looking... Well, okay, yeah, I was going to say it's not looking good for B-Climber. It's really not good for B-Climber because he lost.
There's not much you can do against that dare.
There's not much you can do when you lose. I mean, either you're down to zero and it's game over.
Once you've lost, you've lost.
Once the tank's empty, you're not driving another mile until you walk 5 miles to get gas. We're starting round two here. Climber down 1-0. Or zero, yeah, 1-0. Climber down. I said that right. Cue ball is just killing it.
Cue ball.
He's not bald, so it's not offensive.
Dude, he's got that. He's got that Falco.
Cue ball punted him off the edge. Holy cow.
Dude, did he just...
Okay. I thought he knocked him
off.
Yeah,
I thought he took another stock.
I was ready for the easy button, man. Climber forced him off the edge, though. We'll see if he can hold it up.
Mmm, them dares. Like butter. The second I say that. Okay, here we go. Ooh, that hard read, but nothing. It wasn't there. It wasn't there.
Well, Climber's trying his best.
Dare.
But it just doesn't seem to be good enough.
Dare. To the Shadow Realm. Good lord.
Yugi boy, you got punted off the edge. If you want to save your grandpa, you'll have to do better than two lives left.
One life, Yugi boy.
I have a feeling Climber believes in the heart of the cards.
He believes. He definitely believes.
But you
believes.
Know what? Sometimes the heart of the cards gives into the seal of Ori Kalkos, and then it's game over. I watched the series. Don't worry about it.
This dude.
I have Egyptian God cards. We don't worry about it.
Okay. No, he just needs to get that Exodia out and obliterate.
Well, no, because that little bug dude on the boat's going to throw your cards off the edge.
And we don't. The shine. Exodia, obliterate. God.
They need to obliterate. Oh, it's game over. They shook hands. Sorry.
There it is.
And Climber's done. Cue ball goes in for the smash there. Mom, I still haven't seen a smash ball. Don't shake your head at me.
Dude, mom is disappointed.
I am disappointed.
I am a disappointed.
Blake, let me get a drink of your water.
Dude, you can't push that if there's no four
stocks.
Yeah,
stock. I can. I can
no, you can't. It's only for four stocks. That was a false easy. That was not easy.
It was a Sam easy. We need to put an I right there and add an E. Let me get a drink of your water.
Oh, yeah.
Tight. I love water. You gotta stay hydrated. Shout out to hydration. Why did your water leak all over everything?
That's what I said. You have to, like, well, not if you do it that way. That's your problem.
No, why don't I put my lips on your bottle?
True.
Well, the bracket's up there. Noah versus Q-Ball. Echo versus Shmishi. You need to bust out them JPN, the Just Positive Neutrons. Uncut Yu-Gi-Oh! References where nerds get stabbed and lit on fire. I've never seen those episodes. Have you?
What? Bust out the...
Season Zero.
Oh, Season Zero? We don't talk about Season Zero, guys.
I've never seen Season... What's Season Zero?
Dude, we don't talk about
what
Season Zero.
What is it? Zero. Hey, I want to know. You can't just leave me out of the loop.
Dude. Don't worry about it. We're getting into this match. Dude,
that's Boslovic. That is what that is.
We got Kai Echo against Smeesh. This is.
And apparently they're fighting in Season Zero. Hey, do you want to hear the most annoying sound in the world? Mom's getting mad.
That's it.
Got him. Calm down, Mom.
Ooh, that duck. Can't hit a monkey with a fire arrow.
Mock. Yeah. Ing. Yeah. Bird. Yeah. Mom King Bird.
All right,
well, Smeesh is looking good, but I mean, it's 140%.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to get smacked up. But then again, if he just gets thrown off in monkey combo. I can feel it.
Smeesh has been hot all night, though, so I wouldn't count out seeing a win from him.
Oh, he wanted it.
Smeesh's 155. Jesus.
He's still in. And he caught him with monkey fist. Alright, but he couldn't hold on to that stop. He wasn't holding on to that stop.
I didn't see it coming.
Them strats, yeah.
Well, Smeesh is still up. And he's up again.
Alright, so Smeesh is... looks like Smeesh is going to take this one. But it's not over yet. Echo still got a life. He is part of Kai, the representative of Kai.
Cobra Kai.
Cobra Kai.
Give him a body bag. Yeah! Dude. Sweep the leg.
He is Trouser Snake. Dr. Fumbles, Trouser Snake.
It was Fumbles. It was always. Shout out to Robot Chicken. Robot Chicken Star Wars is probably the best Star Wars parody.
It was really, really hilarious.
Family Guy tried. I don't know if South Park did one. I haven't seen every South Park.
I don't think so.
Robot Chicken's one of the best, if not the best, Star Wars parody out there.
Definitely.
Donkey takes a stock down. But, I mean, he's about to destroy Echo.
Yogi Bear.
Come on, boo-boo boy. Yeah. Let's get this picnic basket. Huh? Oh, so we done? Oh, no.
Dude,
that's fine.
That's cool, man.
Well, no, we have to sign off. Well, we're getting replaced by better commentators than No Smash.
Dude.
So, this is Sam signing off.
Blizzy, I'm out.
Deuces, thanks for listening to our bad jokes.
Thanks, y'all.
GG, good game, good night, and go grab some bench.
Hello, chat. It is I.
Hi,
and
chat.
He.
Who's even in here? Oh, we don't even have a mouse.
Do we all need a mouse?
Is this a touch screen? Let me know. Okay, maybe. Okay, we're mid-game, so we should probably talk about it.
Why'd we switch out mid-game? It's a bad idea.
Yeah, maybe that's why they said hurry.
Uh-huh.
All right, so this is game two of Echo versus Smeesh. Smeesh rocking the Donkey Kong like he just doesn't care. And Echo playing Young Link confusingly
like
because he does care.
Yeah, he does believe.
He does believe in Young Link.
Echo's my low-tier hero right now.
Yeah.
Tizer started playing Fox, so he can't be my low-tier hero anymore.
Well, that's too bad. okay, so it looks like Smeesh won the first game and is barely winning this one right now. This is probably a pretty hard matchup for Donkey Kong. I have no idea how a matchup like this works. But, I mean, Young Link has about 2,000 projectiles, so...
Yeah, this is a very good matchup for Young Link. Few and far between as those are.
Yeah. One thing I've noticed about Echo is he does a really good job of using his Zare. He throws people off a lot with it. Right there.
No one expects it because it's not a very good move.
No.
But it's got a ton of range on it.
Yeah, exactly. And it looks like it comes out pretty fast as long as you use it well enough to the ground and not get pooped on afterward. But so now Smeesh's lead is looking a little more definitive, but Echo's looking to turn that around pretty quickly here.
And the thing about Echo, his follow-ups with Young Link are so nice. One hit like that, that's the stock.
Yeah, he does a really good job of managing projectiles, it seems. And, I mean, yeah, following up out of those projectiles, too. It's an interesting choice on stage to Zare like that, but he made it work.
Yeah. And I think, I mean, part of that might be remnants from playing Project M, where the Link's Zares are better moves. But
yeah, Tink's Zare is pretty good. Riptizer 2014.
Alright, so now Echo's opting to play more of the camping game, which is perfectly fine for this matchup. You can just throw a projectile and wait for DK to approach.
And it works. I mean, against Smeesh especially, he's a pretty aggressive Donkey Kong. And just,
as we see with the ledge hop Donkey Punch.
Donkey Punch. Love it. Alright.
Echo loves to edge guard with these boomerangs, throwing them off to essentially cover recovery options.
Yeah, and it's a really good idea because it forces your hand in a way to recover to a certain part of the stage if you've got multiple options there to begin with. Makes it a much easier time for him to predict where they're going.
Right, and Echo's kind of turned this game around.
Yeah, man, he's stepping it up.
Echo with a solid stock lead.
Okay,
oh, and
that
down
two.
Smash poke. Donkey might as well just not have a shield when it comes to lanes down.
Yeah, that's pretty true.
That move's already real good at poking. And
is this 3 out of 5 or 2 out of 3?
2 out of 3.
2 out of 3 says Cam Tendo.
Winner semis.
Looks like we just... Okay. We're going into game three on Fountain of Dreams.
On Fountain of Dreams.
An interesting counterpick from Donkey Kong. I don't know what made him choose the stage.
So I would imagine that Echo banned Yoshi's.
And he's just trying to force him not to be able to use too many projectiles.
Right, he wants a smaller stage.
Yeah, makes sense. Unfortunately, Fountain of Dreams is kind of a double-edged sword because of the fact that it does mess up a lot of throw combos that Donkey Kong has based on the variable height.
Oh my goodness, Echo! He made
He's
that
back.
Back.
He's back.
Young Link's recovery in this game is super situational. Down to, I mean, it changes depending on what version of the game you're playing.
Yeah. yeah.
But if you can make use of every single one of the tricks in Young Link's tool bag, like Echo can, then you can recover from hell far away.
Yeah, and Echo's really just putting the pressure on against Donkey Kong here, and just like, even though it's a small stage, using bombs as often as he can, just following up out of him pretty much every time he gets a connection. That was really good. That was a really good read.
Yeah, and notice how he's using his boomerangs here to kind of read where he thinks his opponent's going to go. So either they'll still go that way, they'll get hit, or they won't go that way anymore, and he can throw a bomb where they're already sitting.
Yeah, makes sense.
SkyZim says this is the best stage in the game.
Well, literally everybody disagrees with you in Nebraska, so I'm sorry.
Oh, SkyZim knows. He's from Nebraska, and he hates being called SkyZim.
Yeah, yeah.
But his name's spelled.
Yeah, we know it's supposed to be SkyZim. But we know it's better for you. All right, pretty even game here.
Are you from Iowa, Schism? I know I saw you at Roll Tier.
I played Peach, and this is my best stage. Yeah, this stage is probably pretty decent for Peach, I imagine. Cam doesn't love FOD, he's lying.
He does play Sheik. Does enjoy FOD.
Okay.
Yeah.
So DK back up in the lead in this game. Not by much, though.
Echo with really strong projectile pressure right now. All right, so that was a bit of a telegraph dare from Echo.
Huh.
And another one, but again, DK shield might as well not exist.
DK, yep.
DK picking up bombs. We got a monkey with explosives here.
Oh!
The first hit of that up B is so strong.
Man,
that was
Smish.
A nice use of that move by Smish.
Takes the winner's semifinal there. Cool. Looks like up next we've got Noah versus David. Should be a pretty good match. Noah has told me before, and maybe this is just because I'm bad, but Falco is one of his favorite matchups as Captain Falcon.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I don't know if that's still true or true against David, because David will probably beat the crap out of him. But doesn't hear the shit talk. He really likes Falco's weight a lot, and combo game against Falco.
That's fair. Spaceys are fun to combo.
Yeah.
And the thing about Noah
and the recovery.
Noah too is like incredibly aggressive and is really good about putting pressure on someone.
Yeah.
And if you can do that on Falco, then it's a good matchup for someone like C Falco.
Yep.
The problem for most people who play like C-Falc or Marth or characters like that is if they want to sit back too much, those lasers just shut them down.
Right. No, right. Or if the other character has a decent amount of space and is willing to play, just,
right.
You know, play the game. Yeah, I don't doubt that. Bowser Jr. I assume that's Tizer, yeah. Ever Tim.
Tizer, how many Twitch accounts do you have? I know of at least this one in Cutie Patootie.
Yeah.
These button checks.
So
there's only Final Destiny.
So minute long button check, apparently.
Or not. Maybe they're just I don't know what's happening. I assume it's a button check.
All right, here they go.
Just remake accounts once a week.
Solid. All right, game one. Okay, so Falco doing Falco things.
Throwing up them, throwing some dares. Throwing some more dares.
And David, okay. You know, I like dare as Falco, but David uses an obscene amount of dares, and he not in a bad way. He makes them work, but like almost every time he approaches. Yeah, that was. It's with the dare. It's crazy.
All right, that was pretty bold on Noah's part, but it looks like it worked out for him.
Yeah. and the behind-the-back grab from Captain Falcon. Classic. Oh, man. Good DI from Noah. He might have died otherwise from that. Okay. Even stocks, pretty even percents.
All right, more Falco, thanks.
Yep.
Noah's pretty good about getting the shield grabs on Falco. Oh, that was a nice perfect shield, but shine too strong.
Yeah, he's not scared to try it, which is not true of a lot of people, so. Oh, man, that was a pretty high laser recovery with Davis Falco there.
Noah got Lombardied a little bit there.
Yeah.
All right, that was a really high bear.
Yeah.
That's good.
I was expecting an up air almost, but.
Real good on David for realizing he could go for that. A lot of people, once, you know, the character gets too far from you, they don't realize they can still go for things.
Yeah. Okay. Oh my goodness. Okay. Not the right read there. David does a really good job of keeping things going as Falco once he gets it started, which is, you know, a necessary skill.
Well, and he sets up his combos in such a way where, you know, he avoids them. He avoids his opponent getting the first tech, which makes it really hard for them to tech later dares.
Yeah.
All right, David with a pretty commanding lead here.
Yeah.
Known to come back from such deficits, but he's got a lot of work ahead of him.
I'm interested to see how David recovers back onto the stage throughout these games, because one thing Noah does, okay, and he capitalizes right there, but one thing he does really well is kind of, he has Falco's recoveries back onto the stage figured out pretty well, just from the sheer amount of time that he's played against him. Okay. And that's probably it? Nope.
Nope, miss times the F smash. Noah getting stuck in the jab.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. That's going to be it for Falco.
And that's game one.
Follow Hype. Saw Ox Shorts. I didn't get the rest
Ox.
Of the name, but thanks for the follow, Ox Shorts.
What's the name of the dude?
Thanks for helping us. Oh, Short Stack. Okay.
Sort Stack. All right.
All right. I only saw the Short Stack.
Short Stack.
Well, thanks for
okay.
helping us get the stream
short
off the
stack.
Ground, Short Stack.
Well,
we appreciate it.
We're trying. All right, game two on Final Destination. Noah does light this stage.
Yeah. I'm not sure about this pick against Falco.
No. I mean, Falco definitely has a pretty significant advantage on this stage, but Noah just really seems to like it.
Yeah, and that's really what the stage pick comes down to. Play the stage that you think that you can win on, right?
Yep. But David's showing that that's not going to be the case if he can help it.
David's saying, you know what? I like this stage too. Let's play this stage.
Tell Mike he is a noob. I don't know where he is, Short Stack. Playing JBM right now, so we'll have to wait. Oh,
right, there was a good forward smash.
Yeah, that was well timed.
Right, that was a good jab from Noah.
Oh my, yeah, there he goes. He reads that tech roll and gets a nice fresh knee on him.
And what David's been able to do, I mean, for most of these two games, is keep Noah from getting that momentum.
Oh my,
that makes him so good at this game. Really nice jab out of that knee to set him back up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Bad trade for Falcon there. Good ledge check from Noah. Everybody air dodges.
On this stage against Noah, you should almost always, if he's recovering from below, I mean, it just makes way more sense to dare as Falco since it can go through the stage, basically. It makes it a much harder time for him to tech the move.
That was a good read on that angle from Noah.
Okay. Oh, and
good
he tries to go
spot.
For the dare that time, but Noah's sweet spot's the ledge.
No, not out of this just yet.
Nope.
Let me say a stock is not a lead. But every trade here is a very bad trade for Noah.
Yep.
He doesn't want to be trading hits like that.
Oh, man.
All right.
Tries
Noah's
to
still in.
Tries to time the D smash, but Noah once again gets a sweet spot. And that's game two. The second game of winner's semis. Good step to David and to Noah. Cool.
Best of five.
D. You calling David Scrubby Tizer?
Man. Shots fired by Tizer, a.k.a. Bowser Jr.
Right.
Yeah, his playstyle is kind of weird, though, Tizer, I agree with you.
So, yeah, future hype time. Farmageddon 2.
Midland Warfare.
Saturday, September 7th. Yeah, not 17th, 13th. Here at the UNL Student Union. Cam, do you know where in the union? Is it in the Multiculturals? Yeah. Heritage Room in the Multicultural Center.
As usual.
It's a good venue. Decent size. Nice little building. You're on lovely city campus.
And what games will there be at Midland Warfare? I mean, Smash is the most important one.
Smash, of course.
Obviously.
I actually don't know.
I'm guessing there will be some other fighting games, Ultra.
Cam, what else at Midland Warfare? We got PM and Melee, right?
There's no PM.
No PM.
Oh, no PM.
Okay.
So, yeah, we got Soul Calibur, Ultra, Marvel.
Melee, no PM.
Melee, no PM, though.
So, a bunch of fighters.
Yep.
It's going to be hype. Join us here on the stream, or join us here at City Campus.
Well, it's all right to get salty every once in a while, Tizer.
Yeah, dude, you're our low. You gotta be a low tier hero. You gotta be ready for some salt. Well, we're not seeing that on stream.
We can't see that. So we got
a button check. Smeesh is just kicking Smeesh poor Ness in the face.
Beating children right now.
Why have people got to beat on the little psychic kid? Speaking of which, we got to hype up next week, Chateau.
Yeah.
Because next week is Teams Week.
I will probably be there, and I will be attending in Teams. If that's the case.
Team Motherboy.
Team Motherboy indeed. That's right. We're gonna go.
It's going down.
I'll probably go with the Soulless Ginger flavor of Lucas.
Soulless Ginger Lucas. I gotta rock PJ Ness. Well, I can't in PJ in Teams, so I'll just have to be Red Ness.
Oh what? Yeah. What color is Ginger Lucas? Hopefully red.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll have whatever Ginger Lucas is, because if it's not PJ's, I don't care.
Yeah.
Not PJ's or Skull T-shirt, but that's not one of the color options either. Anyways, Teams Week going to be super hype. There's going to be silly combos. It's going to be funny as hell. No singles next week, but Teams galore. It's going to be fun.
Yep. In both events, right? In Melee and PM?
Yep. If this goes well, we're going to try and get a we're going to try and do, you know, more nights like that. We've had suggestions for like a low tier tournament 1 week.
Yeah, that'd be fun. I would get bopped. But
I had an idea for like a random tournament. Everybody just picks random every game.
Oh man, the salt would flow. The salt would flow,
yeah,
like
salt
crazy.
Salt would it would be abundant. So we got button checks going on right now.
Yeah, more buttons being checked.
I mean, you can only check your buttons so much, right? Once you've checked them once, you'd think they'd be good.
Dude, how can smashes be real if our buttons aren't real?
Shoutouts to Michael, God tier TO.
Yep, just standing there being the Jolly Green Giant. Minus the green.
Michael used to live with us, but he doesn't now, and we miss him.
He just yells at me to get a cat all the time. All right, we're in game one. So, Misha just jumping around the lasers a little bit, but he can't jump around them forever. He's got to approach someday. He tried, but Falco is stuffing him with those dares right now. Uh-oh.
Smeesh still wearing the Kong tag.
Yeah.
Repping Donkey Kong in spirit, if not in practice.
Yep, yep. Oh my goodness.
All right, so David goes for pretty read there. It would have been pretty. All right, misses that attack, gets neat. Such is the way of Falcon.
Oh my, okay.
All right, Smeesh is feeling it right now.
One of the unfortunate things about Falco is how much you can do and then die.
And, you know what they say, Falco spawns at kill percent.
Yep, yep.
All right, good fake out from Smeesh.
All right, pretty close game here. So another thing David is pretty good at, I've seen, is right there actually. He's really good at doing retreating dares on people's shields, which is super old school, but it's something that people like Bomb Soldier used to do, and it works. I mean,
well,
it's just not the most
smart,
technical
right?
thing to do on somebody's shield.
Because a lot of people want to do out of a misplaced or misspaced dare is to shield grab, but
yep, exactly.
You're backing up.
Yep.
Then you just got a whiff grab to play off of.
Yeah, he dares high and then oh my gosh. Smeesh going
Smeesh
for the
is going
BM
for
right
style
there.
Now.
Alright. Nice. Even stocks, even percent once again. Smeesh is doing a good job of not being intimidated by the lasers or getting caught off guard by them too much.
No, and he's also throwing out, you know, his own, he's kind of just throwing out some of these raw knees. He's putting that pressure back on David.
Totally aligns with his play style.
Yeah. Alright, so David misses the ledge there. Wanted that edge guard.
Oh
the
that's
laser.
A nice, laser to F smash, classic. Oh man.
Oh. These jabs.
So, yeah, Falcon's Nair, really one of his best options against Falco.
Yeah, absolutely. It's actually, and a lot of people
it's really
don't realize this, it's a hard move to space well. The fact that people like Smeesh can space it so well so consistently is
yeah.
actually pretty impressive.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Smeesh going for a little, David going for a little bit of shield pressure, trying to get something started.
Just Falco, thanks.
Pretty much.
Smeesh is also getting a lot of these power shields on the lasers, which really just kind of shut down Falco's approach.
Yep.
He's trying to use the lasers to approach.
Yeah, yeah. The important thing is Falco is even if you get hit, you just keep driving. All right. Decent read attempt by Smeesh there, but he misses the dare.
All right. Gets a sour spot on the dare there. That could have been a stock for David. But
little technical flub there on this shine. Oh. Okay, this could be it. Nope. And people have said that this is the biggest thing that Nebraska Smashers need to work on is their offstage or their wedge guarding game and offstage game.
Yeah, absolutely. Not to take anything away from Smeesh, he was really good about, you know, trying to fake out David and use Captain Falcon's limited recovery to its fullest.
Absolutely. It's a lot. I don't know. It's a lot harder to edgeguard Falcon when he's above like that, just because he can change up his speed and everything so much.
Yeah. Well, and it's a bad recovery. It's more predictable than most, but it's not entirely predictable. You can fake people out.
Yep, for sure. And another good perfect shield by, or power shield rather by Smeesh. Oh. Soft spot knee. Wow. Tries to go for some fancy moonwalk action. Another power shield. Okay. I'm interested by the fact that they went back to Dreamland. actually.
So where do you think Smeesh should have gone?
I don't know. A stage that would have been a little more suffocating for Falco, I would say. But, you know, it's kind of a two-way street in this matchup just because it can be really hard to get out of Falco's grasp if you're on a small stage.
Well, and I feel like the stages, especially with Captain Falcon, that you pick are super, like, style-based.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I mean, some Falcons are just going to prefer the longer stages where you got kind of your runway.
Yeah.
And then some are going to prefer the smaller stages where you can get those easy, quick kills.
Yeah. All right. Nick back after another power-up sesh.
Oh, my. Just kind of falls off the side of the stage.
Smeesh loses his jump and dies. Okay.
Alright. Yep. We've started PM, yeah.
Okay, Falco holding onto his stock. 140% is pretty unusual for this character. So good stuff to David for holding on. Alright. There it is. Dumpster.
Alright.
He probably
Everybody
I
dies.
Think he might have had his No, oh wait, no, he got hit. Never mind, he didn't have his jump.
You think he might have been able to live there with a if he had firebirded like upwards and diagonally?
No, I don't think that. Especially not a diagonal Firebird would have gone further horizontally, so.
Yeah, I guess they don't.
Oh my goodness, the dares. Too strong. See, this is what I'm talking about right here.
Oh my goodness.
So many dares, so little time.
All right, this is Winner's Finals. It is best 3 out of 5. Noah is coaxing Smeesh to go DK. I am all for that.
All right. Oh, not?
So no salty runbacks. Oh, name Johns.
Solid. I'll add you.
Okay, salty
runbacks.
Wait,
what happened? Dude, I wouldn't have done that. Oh, yeah. All right, we're in game 3. Dreamland again. Smeesh is intent on winning on this stage.
He wants the honor.
Oh, excuse me.
All right, nice dare to knee there.
Yep. All right. And that's a stock right there. Smeesh has got pretty decent lead right now. But Falco can turn that around with one combo.
That was a good get up attack there.
Capitalizes on a missed tech. Manages to get back to stage. He's really good at faking people out.
Well, and it's really hard when you don't expect to go off stage like he just did.
Yeah. Oh.
To be able to react quickly enough to get back on without getting edge guarded.
Yeah. That was really smart. He saw that Noah was on the platform and went for a really high laser recovery to try and hit him.
All right, so for the first time, we got Smeesh with a fairly commanding lead here. Oh, maybe.
And Falco's still back. Tried to. I think he probably could have kneed him out of that. Oh well. One thing that people forget a lot is that Falco's Firebird doesn't have a hitbox until it's actually moving, unlike Fox's. So a lot of people are less willing to go after it than they should be. All right,
David
still
getting a little
on.
Overzealous there.
Yeah. Okay. Oh. Well, not the worst percentage that could have happened at, but still a little unfortunate given that it is Dreamland. Okay. We're seeing a much different game from Smeech in terms of how he's playing. He's playing like a lot less aggressively. Really just trying to wait until David makes a mistake, and he's been doing a good job of it so far.
Yeah. Maybe he's just hustling the first two games. That'll make it interesting.
Yeah, well, that would not be unlike him. All right.
The quick all right, last laser stock. To there.
This is tournament stock for Smeech. Or, well, game stock, or set stock, I suppose.
Smeech trying to get these reads out of the down throws.
Yeah.
But
not
David's
not
predictable enough for him.
You'd think with how often these guys play, you know. But if they play enough,
all right,
he's gonna learn how to not.
We got a game for Smeech.
That's right.
He ain't out of this yet.
The struggle continues.
He says, "Don't put me down in the losers bracket just yet."
We got some. We got a Triforce in the background now.
Ba-na-na-na!
I don't know what else is happening. Some facts. Some Marth.
Hey Noah. Senpai.
Alright,
Brand, do me a favor and bring me my Gatorade bottle. On that table.
So, Fountain of Dreams is a really good counterpick by David. It's a perfect level to stuff out Captain Falcon and just make sure he doesn't get any combos going because of the different heights of the platform. However, Falcon's keeping it pretty even here. Oh, nope.
Very good use of the wall jump.
Oh, that was a good laser to stop him in his tracks on that recovery.
All right, and David reads the Raptor boost.
Oh, there you go, the stomp to knee.
We have a request that you draw a Pikachu.
Oh my gosh, the combos. Falco can combo super well on this stage, I'm just really bad at it. Oh, that was a good double dip
just Falco things.
Yeah.
Double dare 2000. Shoutouts to Nickelodeon.
Devon, please. Coming from Tizer. Yeah, I mean these platforms, like Falco can just bounce people off them all day.
Well, and because of the way they move, sometimes it's hard to get attack off of a dare.
Yep. Yep. Oh my gosh.
More
dares. So many dumpsters happening.
Dares.
Oh!
Smeech saves him.
Smeech saves him with a command grab right there.
He says, "I'm not done with you yet." Pulls the scorpion. Get over here.
Oh, good get-up attack from Captain Falcon. Captain Falcon still got fight in him.
All right.
Looked like a phantom laser there, and that'll be it.
And that's it.
GG's.
David moves on to Grand Finals, and Smeech into Losers Finals. Up next, we've got Noah versus JBM.
Dude, that's a pretty good Pikachu. If I were to see it without like being told what it is, I would know that it's Pikachu.
I didn't want to drink hard things tonight.
Where is this? I'm not sure. Is this like? Oh, it's Marf. He doesn't have a tiara.
Sorry.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. He does have the flow.
What? I'm JD Fresh now?
JD Fresh.
Oh, God.
John Marth.
He got closer, he has a gun.
Disclaimer, I'm not even one
Fox 200th is pretty
as good as Pink Fresh.
The fantastic so, Mr. Star Fox.
Keep that in mind, everybody.
Hey. If y'all haven't watched it, there's a Funnier Die video called The Fantastic Mr. Star Fox.
Oh, it's awesome.
It's funny as all get out.
It is fantastic. And it has Star Fox.
It does have Star Fox. And Falco Lombardi.
All right, so we got hand warm
JBM.
Skis. Nope.
Nope, they're going into it.
Okay.
Lots of dash dancing.
So Fox versus Captain Falcon. A little harder than Falco versus Captain Falcon for Captain Falcon, I think. I mean, people have differing opinions on it, but...
Yeah, it's probably up to the player.
Yeah, well...
To be honest.
Yeah, just... Just as anything is, but Fox being able to move at the speed Captain Falcon does, and having such sweet weight or shine game like that.
Yeah, JBM really loves his shines with Fox. Yeah. I was playing friendlies with him earlier, and he would just shine me across the stage.
Yeah, I mean, if you watch him practice, I was watching him practice earlier. That's like all he was practicing was wave shining across the stage. All right, and anyway, we got a pretty even game one going on Dreamland again. So I think Smeech just must be a pretty big fan of this stage.
Oh, this is Noah.
Noah.
Yeah, he's still rocking the Kong tag for some reason.
Yeah, that's what confused me.
But this is an in-house battle here. We got the Velvet Room versus the Velvet Room.
Yeah, yeah. Only one can emerge victorious.
There can be only one.
Okay.
Noah trying to style there.
Yeah. Noah doesn't even do that for style. That's like legitimately how he edge guards most of the time.
Right.
Is reverse knees.
But in that instance, he could have just held the ledge.
Yeah, good point.
As he gets on my ass to do all the time.
Yeah. And he tries to hold the ledge there, but Fox makes it back because he's Fox. All right, Fox is up 3 stocks to 1. 139%, so he'll die from one knee anywhere. Or a bear.
Or the bear.
Spacey killer, as we call it. All right. Noah trying to space, and then going in for a raw knee. Ooh. Catches him with an up smash. Yep, and there's
very
the reverse
good.
Knee he's been looking for all this time.
Noah's super good at getting that hitbox.
He knows they like the back of his hand.
Or the back of his knee.
Dude, no, that's where the soft knee is. The back of your knee.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
All right, game one going to JBM. Rocking the Fox.
I wonder how long PM's been going on. I'm supposed to be playing. I haven't played a game yet. But...
True. Okay. All right, doing our stage picks here. Back to Dreamland. All right. It's all about
Salty
the Dreamland tonight.
Run backs.
Oh, good catch on. Oh, my goodness.
And there it is. Just Fox.
That's the stock. That's the stock, folks.
Hashtag Just Fox things.
I don't know if you guys have seen Fox before, but he's
pretty good.
He's at least mid tier in this game.
All right, that was a good crouch cancel from JBM.
Yeah, he was trying to set another one of those bad boys up. Oh, my.
Noah says, nope. Coming back, and I'm coming back strong.
Oh, man. And once again, he could have just held the ledge. All right, stomp.
There it is.
The Falcon freebies.
We in this. We living. All right, JBM taking advantage of the missed tech with the up tilt there.
Got some decent damage on that. Oh.
I know, trying real hard for that edge guard.
All right.
Captain Falcon's best edge guard.
Yep.
The dare.
No nipple spike, though, as Jerry goes ahead and meteor cancels.
JBM really liking these dares. And he likes to get the sour spot on them, too, so they just kind of hold you there.
Yeah. Yeah, normally people don't like, don't really like having the long hits from the dares, just because it makes it weird. They like the timing weird, but seems to be all right with it. Okay, bears in the wrong way, unfortunately, and that's a D. All
right, Noah holding on to this stock. He says, I'm going to at least do some damage to you.
Noah likes to knee when he's recovering to the stage when people don't expect him to. And it works out for him a lot of the time.
All right, that was a good, you know, Samus up tilt there.
Yeah.
You don't see Falcons doing that a lot, but it's a decent edge guard.
Yeah, Falcons up tilt is really a pretty decent move, but it's definitely underutilized. I mean, all of his tilts are really, well, okay, not his down tilt really, but his forward tilt is pretty good too.
Oh, loving the Raptor boost.
Yeah.
Oh, please, just roll.
Okay. They were dancing there for a little bit, but Noah.
You'll notice
gets
Noah, every time he gets a kill, he turns around and moonwalks.
He's got to keep himself fresh. Oh, man. JBM saw that roll coming. Okay. Noah's not going down without a fight, even at 147%. All right.
Loser semis goes to JBM. Who knocked JBM into losers?
I don't remember.
Was it
David?
All right, here we go. Losers finals. Best five. Fox only. No way.
Tizer.
Final destination.
Yeah, that depends on who's playing for sure. It depends on who he's playing for sure because he knees the shit out of me when I don't tech. So it against good players if you don't tech, I mean he's probably not gonna expect it, but.
Button checks.
I think they're going into it. All right. So this is game one on Battlefield this time. A change of pace from Dreamland.
Wispy's real sad about it. I'm not.
Yeah. It's that music, man.
Yeah. That first hit of that upbeat. Who is it that you see you fish it? You'll see fish it use that all the time.
Okay. So DK actually upright. Oh, well. As I say it, I eat my words.
Commentator's curse.
Ooh. Oh, that was good coverage though. He covered two options on that forward air.
Yeah, that's one of the benefits that DK has is that he covers a lot of the stage.
Yep. Just see, and that's the kind of thing Noah needed to do as Captain Falcon is just hold the ledge. Okay. That was some good DI from JBM to make sure he didn't get up aired into oblivion. And that's a stock. Really even here. Not something you would expect between Donkey Kong and Fox, but it happens.
All right. And if JBM can just keep doing that, can keep being patient and waiting out things like that upbeat.
Awesome short in there.
I didn't even know you could combo into the up B like that. That was pretty cool.
Yeah. Got some PM hype going on in the background.
PM hype? I'm hyped for PM.
All right, 1-1.
All right, can't miss those tacks on the platforms or DK is just going to run away with you.
Yep. Yeah, and Smeesh is really good at his follow-ups, as like every character. Oh, and with an unfortunate SD, that's game one. Oh, thanks, Tizer. I wasn't like trying to degrade myself. I was just saying that I don't play as well as people that are being streamed right now. Also, I don't play Melee anymore. So there's that.
Yeah. Melee, I'm losing interest in Melee myself. Like, I'll still play here at Chateau, but I don't really practice it anymore.
Yeah, I'm just really scared for Smash 4 just because I'm really not sure what it's going to mean for Project M.
Well, I'm sure Project M will retain a very strong following, though I'm hyped for Smash 4. It's looking like it's going to be a fun game.
I'm excited to try it out. But yeah, like my main thing is like I just don't know if PM will still be in active development when Smash 4 is going on. But we'll see.
But we got Project M 3.5 coming out pretty soon.
Yeah, and that's going to make me sad in the pants about Lucas, but that's fine. All right, game two on Final Destination. Probably a pretty good counter pick from JBM here. No platforms for DK to juggle with. It's really just a giant platform for Fox to combo on.
Yeah. Well, and he also gets his shines, right?
Yep.
He likes to shine across the stage, and DK is a very good target for that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And this stage is just a runway.
Yeah. Yeah, and he already is proving that he has a command on this stage. So 11%, and DK is already down a stock. Oh, and here we go. Oh.
All right.
Oh, man.
Doesn't matter, Fox.
Tries to keep it going there. Yeah, Cam, DK City in terms of DK getting comboed like this. Yeah, that's true. That's true, Tizer. I mean, you could probably combo Fox with U-airs on this stage a pretty decent amount, but I still feel like platforms are probably overall better.
Yeah, for DK, I'd probably have to agree. If it's a character with maybe a little stronger U-air combos or up throw combos, then FD's a good choice.
Oh, man. Just going in with the... Oh, wow. That was some long stun. What was
Smeesh
that? A dash attack?
Like he's almost not sure how to react out of that. I don't think he expected to get that hit.
No. All right. Another up smash for the kill.
Alright.
Oh boy. Alright, this could be what Tizer's talking about here. Alright, yeah, he just puts in a quick like 90%.
Yeah, that is pretty nuts. I stand corrected. Oh my goodness.
Triple wave shine into an up smash.
And I like the addition of the up smash in there, I think.
Yeah,
he was expecting him to shine him again.
Yeah.
But he says, nope, I'm going to take you to the ledge, and I'm going to up smash you. I'm going to kill you off the top.
Yeah, why not? He's at 100%.
All right, start off game. More Fox things.
Okay. 51% off those shines.
JBM says, you want a ton of damage in your combos? I can have that too.
And I'm surprised that Smeesh went back here after a pretty dominant victory from JBM.
Yeah.
I would have expected a different stage. I don't know. Battlefield, even.
I mean, they are called salty run backs for a reason. It could just
be he may just be upset
that he lost so badly there.
Oh, here we go. He was just feeling himself out of those combos at the end of the game.
Yeah, that could be. There you go.
All right, all right. Keeping it even.
Keeping calm, holding the ledge. JBM says, have some lasers in your face.
Mm. Oh, nice.
Smeesh is real good about stalling at the ledge with DK.
Yep. Wow, yeah, that was, he did a good job DIing correctly there. But Fox is Fox.
All right, just throws out the raw donkey punch. Nobody's business.
But Fox has the 69 factor.
Yes, he does.
Oh, keeps it going. Oh, all right, it's over.
That's the best trade ever for Smeesh.
Yeah.
He got rid of the 69. That is the secret percent. All right, JBM getting a little overzealous with that grab there.
Oh, man. That was interesting knockback from the forward air.
Yeah.
Didn't expect it. I don't know if Smeesh did either at all.
All right, good back throw. Talk about a spacey killer.
Fox almost makes it back.
Tosses him over his shoulder like a used tissue.
I'm done with you. All right. Oh.
All right.
Goes for a donkey punch.
Smeesh getting a little greedy there after having some real solid edge guards. All right. Let's see if we can get some more DK combos.
That's too bad that Smeesh didn't connect with a hit on his attempt there after hitting JBM in the air. This could be it. Nope. And there it is. Man, Tizer's facepalming. He's upset at a lot of things right now.
Tizer is hashtag facepalming.
All right, where do you think we're going now? I'm going to say BF.
No. Oh, they're randoming. That's why.
Okay. Man.
That's all right. I can dig the randoms.
Yeah, I mean, this isn't a great random for Smeesh.
I mean, Michael said, gentleman's agreement trumps everything. I'm going to try and get someone to play a pirate ship with me in PM tonight.
Oh, dear.
This is my favorite stage in that game. It's so much fun.
All right.
Oh. DK says, take a look at my booty. All right, JBM with the factor again.
Yep. Oh.
DK taking it away from you with his bad dash attack. I think that may be DK's biggest improvement in Project M is the replacement of that dash attack.
Interesting that he decided to up smash there when DK wasn't even at 50%. That was... I don't know. I don't see people stall with shines on stage very often like that.
The shield pressure from
Smeesh
DK
is working so hard to keep himself just at arm's length with Fox.
All right, Smeesh taking a stock.
Interesting F smash.
C stick hero.
All right. This is Pokey. He was actually at a pretty high percent, so.
All right, good jab reset from Smeesh. All right,
and
let's get some percentage.
Up
tries to follow him off that platform, but JBMD dies out.
I'm intrigued by the fact that he didn't just turn around and try to bear him there. But, you know, he's the DK player and I'm not, so... Oh!
Oh!
He was so close on that.
That was some pretty solid spacing, just a little bit too far.
Man, manages to just... gently touch that wedge every time. Okay, that's a stock. Fox up by a commanding, like, full stock right now.
But, if Smeesh can get off another one of those U-air combos,
yep,
he can even this back up. All right, JBM getting a little patient here.
Yeah.
Willing to just sit back and capitalize whenever Smeesh makes a mistake.
Pretty much, yeah, every time he swings and misses,
all right,
he's getting some shines.
Losers Finals goes to the Velvet Room, JBM.
Yep.
Walking kids down the street indeed, Dizer.
Good stuff to Smeesh. Rocking the low tiers through and through. And now you know what it's time for.
Grand Finals.
Grand Finals!
Yo.
It's time. What is... Okay, so what happened with this drawing? What is this?
That's Night Brulee. Praising the sun.
I don't know, man.
He wishes he could be so grossly incandescent.
I've seen that quote so many times, and I don't play that game, so.
Yeah, we got, like, early bracket rounds of PM going. Like, early bracket rounds of PM are going. The brackets, talk to Michael.
Yeah, talk to Michael about it. Ugh. All right, so we've got JBM and David coming up in Grand Finals. Some Fox versus Falco, potentially Marth versus Falco. I'm interested. I don't know which matchup these guys are more comfortable with.
I would assume that JBM is more comfortable with the Marth matchup.
I kind of feel the same way. Spacey's, I mean, playing against another Spacey as a Spacey is tough.
Yeah.
It's just so much. I mean, they're the only two of their kind in the game, so it's just a different, completely different game.
And I mean, Marth has, I mean, he has his tools against Spaceys, and there's a very specific way in which you use them.
All right, I think we're getting into this.
Yeah, these guys don't need button checks. They've been button checking all day. Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, I think this is game one.
If so, sad first stock for David.
Yeah.
All right, Tizer says JBM Fox gets...
This is a game. Sorry about that, folks. All right. So it's...
Right, that, was a,
even
that was
up.
A good read for the forward smash there.
Yeah, I missed some stuff there.
That's I mean, one of the biggest things for Falco is knowing how to get that forward smash.
Yeah.
Because it's such a strong kill move.
Yeah, it is. I mean, when you're not killing off stage, you better be killing with that. Oh my god, that tiny shield.
Tiny, tiny little skittle of a shield. JBM's going to want to keep the pressure on here so he doesn't have to use that for a bit.
Yeah, and he's also going to want to make sure he gets back to center stage. I mean, Falco will eat you up on the wedge if he knows what he's doing. Oh, and there's an example.
Capitalizes that miss tech. Just that little bit of space between Fox and the stage was all he needed to send him off.
JBM punishes him for that floating shine there. Good turnaround.
And the down smash. Very nice.
Yep. Alright. Some spacey combos. Oh, I missed dash attack somehow.
Alright.
Oh, okay.
Both players kind of feeling each other out a little bit. JDM yeah. going for F smashes.
Oh man, that was almost a killer right there. Falco is in control right now.
And really, I mean, that's what Falco does best, right? Is he controls the stage.
Yep.
And you let him do that, he's going to roll over you.
Yep. But Fox does a good job of not letting him do that because he goes, like, twice as fast.
Got to go fast.
But regardless, Falco does take game one of Grand Finals. Still Fox. Falco.
All right, these up throw combos.
Trying to make sure that we got the game going.
Everybody gets up throw combos on Spaceys, even Spaceys.
Probably it, yeah.
Good there.
Standard. Okay. Oh.
Yo, Michael, I am on the PM bracket, right? I feel like I am.
Okay, so Falco's in the lead. He's trying to keep things going against Fox. This is I don't know who wins on this stage, honestly. People argue about it so much, and I just have no idea. I feel like this stage probably Falco slightly.
I would agree. Thank you.
Overall in the matchup, I think Fox slightly, but
yeah.
But this stage, I think, is in Falco's favor.
Yeah, definitely.
So I mean, it must just be a comfort thing for JVM, which is totally understandable.
Yeah,
I think he just likes to stage every character.
And I do think the Falco advantage on this stage is small enough where something like comfort can
pretty well
override it.
But here we go. I don't know if I agree with him. He kind of backed off the ledge there when Fox was recovering. A little bit. Oh, good down smash though.
All right, throwing those lasers. Oh, that DI.
No amount of DI
was going to save him, but that was, you know.
That was rough. That was rough. Oh my gosh, that was, man.
There's some
that
good
was
tech chases
good,
from JVM
like,
right
fake-outs
now.
From JVM.
Ooh. Oh. Oh.
Yeah, you do something like that against the space animal, you are paying the price. Ooh. Oh, man.
Up smash
racking
combos.
Up the damage. Big damage.
Fox is a good character, guys.
Wow. Just like that,
oh
we've
my
got
goodness.
A much more even game.
Yeah, Dave's got to do a better job of DIing out of the up throw. It's a fast throw. It's hard to DI out.
Oh, man. That was almost a really good ways to reset. Oh, tiny shield.
All right.
Good stuff.
Sure, Dave is looking for a better punish than that. All right,
that's game two. 1-1. Hi, Darren.
Darren in the
it's
house.
It's going pretty well. How are you? We're commentating this grand finals. That's what we're doing. Yeah. All right, game three.
Falco says, I got combos too.
On
you're
Fountain
spacey
Dreams.
Just like me.
David appears to be one of the few people in the Nebraska Smash scene who is a big fan of Fountain Dreams. I guess I've seen a couple of people in chat, but he really did just dominate that stock there. Yeah, he DI'd that first up throw, so that was some good progress. Okay, Fox quickly brings it back.
Alright. David's sitting over here firing lasers off the stage and somehow it works.
He's got these eyes, man.
Alright. Now David's done a dangerous thing here. He's given JBM the factor. Alright, and then he takes it away. Says the good Falco giveth, the good Falco taketh.
Oh, great down, nice smash. Down smash. Just catching him with the edge bit. Alright. Alright.
Alright, good edge guards from JBM.
That was some good
Cam
stuff.
Cam being a dick over here. Mom. Mom Tendo.
Alright, the stage control, I mean, well, especially just being in center stage is important in this matchup like no other. It's like unreal how much different.
So much hit stun.
That was pretty intense.
He had time to charge that a little bit, dude.
Falco goes for the up smash there, trying to emulate Fox a little bit. Alright, we've got a one-stock game here.
Dude, what if Fox and Falco were furries and they dressed as each other?
I don't even know what to say to that. Okay, so looks like David's going to close this one out.
All right.
Yep, and that's
JBM it. JBM gets the tech.
All right, so this is game four.
I believe so. Grand finals, best of five.
David up 2-1. Right now, David coming from winners, JBM from losers.
Yes, yes.
All right, Pokemon Stadium. This is a pick that makes a lot of sense. Okay, so it's interesting because I see David at full jump height a lot.
Yeah.
Like more than I would expect from a Falco player, which is, I mean, part of why, as Heiser mentioned before, he's got it. You can see that he's got a kind of unorthodox style, but it works out for him.
Yeah.
He's got a very commanding style in terms of his mental game.
Absolutely. Unfortunate for JBM, they're missing the ledge.
Yep.
Definitely hard to get that angle.
What?
All right, here we go. Shine dares.
Drops down and shines.
More
on
dares.
The ground.
More dares.
Oh, good tech from JBM. JBM is so good about teching. And David dies there, a little unfortunately.
David says, "And yeah, you know, I know at the end of the last game sucked. That's for you. It's my little gift."
Oh my goodness. Double shine. Shines. Going for the triple. Oh my!
Going for the read after the tech had already happened.
Yeah.
He says, "This is how hard I'm reading you right now."
Good edge guards. Good edge guards.
There you go. The hitbox on that dare covering Falco's entire body. He's just like, "I am a giant drill of doom."
Okay. This part of the stage really dangerous for Falco.
Both of these guys just. Man, they don't care. They're going to be aggressive about it.
Okay. Stage change is...
All right. F-smash ties it back up. Up-smash ties it back up. This is Foxland.
Good F-tilt from David. Oh, my God.
David just goes back to the center of the stage. He says, he's dead.
All right, you're dead. Oh, wait, no, you're not.
JBM says, not today.
Ooh, whiffs on that back air. Trying to finish him off. Okay, good back air.
All right.
It's now up 2-1 in David's favor. This could be the end of Grand Finals.
All right.
If JBM doesn't change up his playstyle a little bit. Okay, but it looks like he's trying to.
Alright, so David capitalizing on that missed tech chase there.
Yep.
The standing laser?
Oh man.
JBM's gonna punish that.
Ooh. All right. That was a good recovery out of the stage.
The dare drill that pierces that booty hole. You are correct, Game Genie. David wants to end this. He says, I want this to be over.
Yeah, it is time for PM. Oh, all right. Well, you know, it's Fox. That's all I'm going to say about the matter.
All right. David's got to be careful here that he doesn't get too eager to end this match and, you know, make some
But that's it right there. Good stuff to both players. Those were some pretty tight games.
It's all good. Congratulations to David. All right, stream. We're going to drop down in a second. We're going to come back up for Project M. I'm going to head out of here because I got games to play. But I think Jordan, a.k.a. JD Fresh, a.k.a. DJ Fresh, so fresh and so clean.
Something like that.
Jorby Danger, I am so dangerous. That's how dangerous I am, Jones. All right. So we're going downstream. See you in a bit.
Yep.